Welcome back to the program where we talk to people who have designed their own success. Now, today it's a very special day here in the studio. I have with me Peggy McCall, New York Times best-selling author and an expert on people becoming magnets in life. And that's what we're talking about today, how to become magnets, right? And Peggy, first of all, thank you for being on the program.
Hey, my pleasure. This is great.
So, you know, we heard it before, but how can we become magnets and attract things into our lives?
Okay, there's really three simple steps. And one of the things that people need to keep in mind is that if you think it's simple, it's going to be simple. If you think it's going to be difficult, it's going to be difficult. So that's kind of like the first step, is to realize that we are magnets. We're attracting stuff into our lives all the time, you know, whether we're aware of it or we're not aware of it. So that's the first step. The second step is to decide, what do you want? What do you want to experience in your life? And once you've decided what you want, then the next step is, what's that going to feel like when you have it? Because that's where we really turn on the magnetic power, is by connecting to our emotions, because we're emotional beings and they're like the switches that control the lights in the room. You ever seen a dimmer switch on a wall in a dining room?
You switch it on and you can, it's like a frequency kind of thing.
Exactly. So the more it's on, obviously the brighter the lights. If you turn it down, the darker it becomes. Our emotions are very much like that. And you're either, you know, being a loving being or you're not being a loving being, one way or the other. So you're either attracting based on those emotions and where you are on your switch or where you're not on your switch. So we're in control of that. You started the show by saying this is a show about how we create our own success. It's like, bang. I mean, you nailed it right there. That's how we create our successes, by realizing we are creative beings.
So there's a lot of people watching this program, and all over the world right now, personal development is a growing industry. There's someone right now, read all the books. They went to the seminars.
Right.
They went to the webinars.
Yeah.
They did everything. But where's the stuff? You know, they're saying, where's the Ferrari? What's all this stuff I'm trying to be a magnet to? What are the roadblocks that people really face when trying to become magnets?
Well, there's a couple things. One is that they didn't do everything. So let's just push that right aside. You know, you haven't. You just haven't thought of something. Yeah. Maybe they were, as the story goes in Think and Grow Rich, 3 feet from gold.
Yes.
Maybe they're...
They're right there.
Breakthrough is right there. They could be there right now. So that's another thing. The other thing is, just as we're talking about powerful emotions cranked on high and emotions on the negative side of things, negative emotions are destructive. Hmm. You could go out in your backyard, and well, maybe not today, but you could plant a garden and put seeds in there and know that they're going to manifest into form, because that's the way it works in nature, right? But if you get frustrated, pissed off, this stuff isn't working, and you go out, even though little shoots are starting to come through, and you start going, this crap doesn't work, and pull them out of the ground, what's going to happen? You've just uprooted everything.
Yeah.
So what happens is people uproot their success before they've even had a chance for it to manifest into form. There's a lot of natural laws of the universe. One of them is called the law of gestation. The law of gestation dictates there is a period of time that must elapse before all things manifest into form. What's all things? Ideas, desires, success. There's a period of time. So maybe it's just around the corner, or maybe you've been sabotaging your own success.
So you have an incredible story where you have, you know, New York Times best-selling author. How many books?
Eight
books. Mm-hmm. Can you imagine? And I'm sure they were all successful. So when was the moment that you knew that this was working for you? I'm a magnet. It's going on for me right now, and this is my moment. What was that moment for you?
Well, I think it's when you start to see results, right? Even though I had faith that the results were going to come, when I started to see results in my own life. And they've come at different times, you know, with either relationships, with finances, with things that I've bought, achievements that I've achieved, like getting on the New York Times bestseller. But as you mentioned, the books, you know, eight books as an example. When I wrote my first book, I didn't have a clue. I was completely ignorant. I didn't know anything about writing books. I didn't know anything about publishing books. And I certainly didn't know anything about marketing books.
Do you think that stops people? Like, they're so focused on the how?
Yeah, absolutely.
They're so focused. I don't know how, so I'm not going to try.
Yeah, you know what I often say when I'm speaking in front of audiences? If there's one message that I can leave with you, it's this. You don't have to know how. You don't have to know how. Just decide what you want. And that's a tough one for a lot of people, because we're sort of conditioned to figure out the how. The first thought is, I want this. Next thought is, that follows it, immediately follows it, well, how am I going to do that? If you don't get an answer, squash, forget it, and you're on to the next thing. Or you'll justify why you can't do it. If you can just let go of the how. You
know, just let go.
Yeah, let go. Like, I have a great story in my book, Your Destiny Switch. And Your Destiny Switch was on the New York Times bestseller list. And this is where I had decided I was going to buy a house. I had no money. You know, I just got divorced from my first husband. I'm happily married now. But at the time, a little boy, my son was 2.5 years of age, no money, and I was focused on buying a house. Now, when you want to buy a house, don't you think you need some of that stuff called money?
So, yeah, that's what we've been trained. You need 25% down,
Exactly. So, or all of the money down. So I actually set the objective, and then a lot of people said to me, you know, what are you even bothering looking at houses for? You have no money. See, they were thinking of the how. I knew I didn't have to figure out the how. So I had a goal card. I carried it with me, and it said, I'm so happy and grateful that I'm living in my beautiful 4-bedroom home. And I described it. And I described what it would feel like to live in it. And over a period of time, I found a home and bought the home and lived in the home for 8 years till I sold it for a very healthy profit and then bought another home. And so, you know, that really comes down to you don't have to know how. I'm living in the Chio Dream of a Lifetime home again right now. There was a story actually in The Citizen a couple of weeks ago. It's my second Chio Dream of a Lifetime home. This home's worth like $1.8 million. When I was looking for houses, I was looking for houses at $1.8 million. I was looking for houses. The house that I had was in Stittsville. It was worth about $800,000, so I was looking in that range. And I thought, you know what? That's not what I want. Now, I know I could go and get another house at that. But what I'm looking for is something different. I'm looking for, and I described exactly what I was looking for and what it would feel like to have it. Now, the price tag that was associated to that was about $1 million more than what I was looking for in the price range. So I thought, well, I don't have to know how. I just have to set my mind on what it is that I want. And now I'm living in that house.
So you went to visit houses?
Mm-hmm.
So do you recommend for people, for example, go test drive the
Absolutely.
Car? Absolutely. Go, you know, and don't test drive the Ford. Go for... Absolutely. The Mercedes, right? Because we're limiting ourselves, right?
Yeah, if you want the Mercedes, go to the Mercedes dealer and test drive the Mercedes. They won't ask you to produce, you know, your bank statement, you know, when you go in for a test drive and get a feel for what it actually feels like. But you got to believe. You really have to believe yourself worthy. This is a big one, worthy of having that in your life. You got to believe you're worthy of success, worthy of love, worthy of money. If you don't believe you're worthy of it, it doesn't matter if it shows up at your door, you'll push it away.
So what's the difference between feeling worthy and being having gratitude? Because both can help you become magnets, right?
Totally.
So how do you
Well, if you imagine our emotions are like on a big panel, like the, you know, you see out in the production room there where they got all the panels of the thing. Yeah. There is an alignment actually between all emotions. Gratitude will lift up all of your positive emotions. Gratitude will lift up your worthiness emotion. But you could be a very grateful person but still think you're not deserving of.
Exactly, exactly.
Right? So you got to pay attention to those emotions that are bringing you down, the ones that are tugging down all the other positive emotions. You see, when my first marriage ended, I noticed it was a common thread through all of the broken relationships that I had. Me, right? I was in the mall, right?
One thing you're sure of, you take yourself with you every time.
That's right. So what's going on here that I'm sabotaging all these relationships? I'm willing to look at that, right? Not to judge myself, not to whip myself in the back or whatever, but just to say, okay, what is it that I'm believing, thinking, you know, consistently doing that's causing me to recreate more destructive relationships? And I thought, okay, I don't believe I'm worthy of love. And that came from a child, like being abused as a child, right? And not feeling loved. No one ever told me, I love you. I remember when I was in high school and I had a boyfriend and he wrote me a letter and he said, I love you in the letter. I cried like a baby. No one had ever told me that they loved me. So I had this worthiness issue. So once I realized it was there, then I could do something about it. Then I decided, okay, I'm going to love myself. I'm going to look myself in the mirror. Louise Hay calls it mirror work, right? You look yourself in the mirror and go, I love you. That's hard at first, right?
Well, I know there's a lot of people watching, and they're very interested right now. They want to be magnets. They're saying, yes, I get the concept.
Yeah.
But what are three tips that you could offer for somebody right now watching this program that they can just take and run with it?
Just think of one thing you want, just one thing. Just start with one thing, you know, to start with. And write that down. You know, what is it? What is it that you want? Now, write it down as if you already have it. I am so happy and grateful. See, that's initiating two emotions, happy, gratitude. Now that I have or am or am enjoying whatever.
And it needs to be in the present tense.
Needs to be in the present tense. You don't have to say by when. Say you have it now. All right, so write that down. Focus on it. Put on a little card so you can carry it with you. I've got a goal card in my purse, wherever we put my purse. And I have my goal card. I don't have pockets in these pants, but if I did, it would be in my pocket. I look at my goal card every single day. I also have a copy of it beside my bed, in my washroom, and on my desk. So I see it all the time. Put it in front of you. See it. Then imagine what it feels like to have it. Like when I was looking at homes that were between $1.5 and $2 million, I imagined what it would be like to have a home like that. So I'd go and open houses. I'd get my real estate agent. You know, at first I called him and said, hey, I want to go look at these houses. He's like, what? Not, you know, would you inherit a, you know, lottery or something? What's going on? He didn't ask me those questions. At first it felt uncomfortable, but you know what? We got to stretch ourselves beyond our comfort zones. Be willing to go beyond your comfort zones.
So you became that person that has the house of $2 million.
Right. You have to step into it, right? If you're not experiencing the things that you want in your life right now, it's because you're not being the person that believes that you deserve them or are worthy of them or can have those things. So it's a stretch, right? There's going to be a period of time, that law of gestation we talked about, that's going to elapse. So decide on what you want, get clear on it, write it out as if you already have it, feel what it feels like to have it. And don't make it a practice, oh, I'll do that for this 5 minutes or the next 2 minutes or while we're watching this show. Make it a daily practice. I actually have a tracking sheet. I track my emotional levels. I track them. Because, yeah, my emotions are, they
like
are.
Like a thermostat.
Yeah, like a thermostat, exactly. Where am I today? You know, am I high on the scale, low on the scale? Now, if I'm low, I'm a human being, right? I get sad, you know, I get frustrated, I'll get angry. It'll happen. I don't whip myself. It's just, okay, what am I going to do to raise up my level?
Nice.
To, you know, and I have switching techniques. So I'll switch if I find that I'm frustrated or whatever. Well, just switch, you know, just we're in control of our emotions. You're not controlling mine. I'm not controlling yours.
Yeah. Well, Peggy, I just want to thank you for coming. Before we leave, can you give us the quote that you live by? What's the quote that kind of resonates with you?
I'd say the quote that resonates with me is by Oliver Wendell Holmes, which is, when one advances confidently in the direction of their goals and endeavors to live the life that they have imagined, they will meet with success, unexpected in common hours.
Peggy, I want to thank you for coming to the program. And I'm sure a lot of people have learned a lot today.
Hey, my pleasure.
That's Success by Design Show.